Hey everyone, in today's video, we are talking CVC words, and I have some activities that I think will really help your students if they are practicing CVC words. Now, to help kind of illustrate today's video, I wanted to pretend that I was pulling a group of students who happen to be focusing on CVC words and reviewing them. So I wanted to walk you through four steps of that lesson and show you what four activities I would use with those students. If you've seen my videos before, then welcome back. And if you are new here, my name is Susan Jones. I'm a former first grade and K-2 literacy teacher who now spends a whole lot of time here on YouTube sharing tips, ideas, and resources with teachers just like you. I spent the last few years home with my two young boys who are now in kindergarten and first grade, and I'm currently finishing up my master's degree in curriculum and instruction. So if you're excited to dive into this video, give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and let's go. Okay, so I said there are going to be four parts to this video, and again, we are focusing on CVC words, but if you are focusing on any other skill, you can pretty much substitute these types of activities with that skill, so keep that in mind. Now, when I would call students over to my small group table, I don't like to waste any time, so I usually have a warm-up ready for them, and for this particular warm-up, I might do something like an alphabet fluency square, and that would look like this. So for kindergarten or first grade, or again, students that are working on CVC words, I might have them have one of these at their spot when they come over, and they will simply go to each square, and they can either, or do both, they can either say the letter B, C, T, S, P, N, or they can say the sound. I would probably have them do both, or if anything, focus on the sound. So B, K, T, S, you get it. So this would just be something that I would have them do until I come over to the table. Now, you don't necessarily have to have a little sheet like this for each of your students. I have these alphabet fluency squares in my literacy club, but you could also just display a group of letters that your students are reviewing on the whiteboard or on a chart paper or something that's available to them when they come over. Now, I have shared a bunch of literacy warm-ups in the past. This is another one that you could throw up on the board. It looks like this. It's called Erase 'Em. Here you can see two word families at the top, and for this, students would simply have to look at the letters down below and figure out which letter could go into one of those to make a real word, and then they could erase it from the board. Now, for an activity like that one, you could have students do it independently and maybe take turns in the group, but I like to kind of check in on that, so if I was having them wait for me, their goal when they get to the table would be to start using those letters to find what real words they can make, so that way they're ready to go when I get there. Okay, so our warm-up is out of the way. That didn't take too long, and that's just something for them to do and a great way for them to review older skills before you come to the table. Now for activity number two, we are going to work on phoneme segmentation. So this would be a simple warm-up that also would not take a long time, but you want to give students 3 to 5 CVC words that they will likely see in this lesson and have them actually segment the sounds that they hear. Now, when segmenting sounds, they can use sound boxes and counters to move up for each sound. They can use Play-Doh that they press down for each sound, or you can simply have them use their hand. So you might say cat, k-a-t. You might show students how to do that, and then you can have them go ahead and segment it on their own arm. And after you model 1 to 2 words, you want them to do at least 3, probably closer to 5 words all on their own. And I shared some common mistakes that teachers make when teaching phonics in a video that looks like this. So I do think this is a good time to point out that when you are having students segment the sounds to these words, you want to not only use new skills that you're teaching, but also throw in some review words that you've already taught in the past. So let's say this week you are focusing on short E CVC words, and last week you did short A CVC words. You will want to include both of those when they are segmenting. Okay, so you did a little warm-up, and you did some phoneme segmentation. Next, I like to move on to decoding. Now, when students are decoding words, I like to have them decode words in isolation and then pretty quickly move into a simple sentence. Now, I have shared these many times before, but I like to use something like this this a one-page decodable because it has students reviewing sounds at the top, then going into those words in isolation, and then going into those sentences. So if you haven't already, you will want to explicitly teach them what that short E sound makes, and you'll also want to show them exactly how to decode some words with short E in them. Then you can simply write some short E words on the board, have them practice decoding them, and then again, put it into some simple sentences. You can see here in this sentence that not only do we have some short E words, but we also have that short A word, sat, for students to review. Okay, so we had students review some sounds with a simple warm-up, we had them do some phoneme segmentation, and we had them do some decoding. What is next? I like to end my small group lessons with students playing some sort of game. That way, in case we are running out of time, I have watched them play the game and kind of seen where their skills are at, and then they can go and continue it without me. So whether they're doing, they can finish that up and then they can go do some independent reading or some other literacy activity. Now the types of games I use are very different. Sometimes they are practicing phoneme manipulation, other times they are practicing encoding or decoding. But in today's lesson, the kind of one I shared with you right now, I didn't do much encoding yet. So I want students to actually spell these words. I want them to be able to tie the grapheme to the phoneme right away. So for today's game, I'm going to share one that I actually shared a few years ago. It is called Mix, Spell, and Color, and it is a freebie that I have for you. So let me show you how to play, and then you can grab it for yourself. Okay, so with Mix, Spell, and Color, this is an encoding game for your students to work on CVC words. So there are a bunch of picture cards included, and each page has at the bottom whether they are short vowel A word, short vowel E. So in this pile, I only have A and E to go along with this lesson that I've created. So what students will do is they will mix up all the cards, they will flip a card or they can pull it out of a bag, and they will have to then write it. We'll pretend this is a whiteboard. So they'll say it aloud, hat, and then on their whiteboard, they would write hat. And then they would go ahead and find which vowel that had in the middle, the A, and they would color in that first box. Then they would flip the next one. Vet. V-E-T. That one has an E, so they would color this in. Now this could definitely be played with a partner as well, and it could also be played with magnets if you wanted to have them manipulate the letters to make the word instead of writing it on a whiteboard. But I usually like to have them write it down so they can actually practice writing their letters as well. But it's that simple. They continue going until one of the vowels reaches the top. So whatever vowel reaches the top first, that means the game is done. So you could see with those cards, I only used short vowel A and short vowel E words because that's what I talked about in this, you know, fake lesson that I made up for today. But you could also do that with all of the cards as a review, and it's a great one to throw in a center. So there you have a layout of how to teach some CVC words, and every single day your lesson doesn't need to look exactly like that, but there are some main parts of teaching these phonics lessons that I want you to be aware of in your own teaching. Number one, make sure you are reviewing old sounds as well as teaching new ones. Number two, make sure you are throwing in some phoneme and phonological awareness practice for your students. Number three, make sure students are practicing decoding words in isolation as well as in sentences. And number four, make sure you are making those grapheme phoneme connections by having students encode words. I could throw in another bonus tip of make sure you are doing some modeling, and you really wanna be careful that you're not doing too much modeling. You really wanna show them how to encode, you know, one or two words before you give them the heavy lifting. Same with decoding. So you wanna do it once or twice and then pass the baton and let them try it out. I hope that sparks some ideas for you to use in your own classroom. And like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, even if you aren't using CVC words, I hope this kind of layout and these types of activities can transfer to different skills for you and your students. And that mixed spell and color game I do have for free for you down in the description below. So make sure you grab that if you want to use it with your students. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel and click that bell. That way you're notified of all my new videos. If you ever have any questions, drop them in the comments. I read them every single week, so I will try to respond to them. And if I see a lot of requests for the same type video or a lot of the same questions, I like to make a video addressing it. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one. Bye.